I hereby call to order the first meeting of the Tortured Poets Department. Hey, hi, hello, my name is Shelly and I am so glad that you are here. Make sure that you hit the subscribe button and the like button and do all the things. So this is my first ever Taylor Swift reaction video. I have been a Taylor Swift fan for quite some time, actually since basically the Folklore era. And here in just a few minutes, in 19 minutes to be exact, the Tortured Poets Department gets released. So I am ready. I have on my black and white. We have my Pat McGrath lipstick, a cardigan, a Taylor Swift cardigan. I have my journal. I have my fountain pen because I am a fountain pen girly. And because I know this album is gonna wreck me, I have my Taylor Swift blanket that my best friend bought me and a cup of caffeinated tea at 11:41 at night. So my journey with Taylor Swift began a long time ago. Like many people, I heard, you know, things from Fearless and Red on the radio, but I was like, oh, that's fine. And then I didn't really follow Taylor Swift too much until Folklore came out. There was one night, my town had a power outage and there was literally nothing to do. So I was like, I might as well listen to Folklore, why not? So in the pitch black dark in my house, lit only by a candle, with a glass of wine, I became a Swiftie. That was my transformation. And now I'm a huge, huge Swiftie. I experienced the Midnight's release, and now I'm so excited to experience the Tortured Poets Department with you. I have some predictions. I think this album is gonna gut me. I've seen online that it's a breakup album, either about Joe Alwyn or that brief Maddie Healy thing. We won't talk about that, or we might talk about that, I don't know. So come with me as I react to all these songs for the first time. Normally, I like to react to an album with nothing going on and like with my headphones or in the car so I can concentrate, but we're gonna do this together. I wish my nieces were here with me or my friends, but it's midnight. Well, it's 11:43 technically right now, and most everyone has to work tomorrow, not me. I took a personal day for this very reason. Well, I needed to take a personal day anyway, and I thought, why not on the Tortured Poets release department day? So I figure maybe I'll film this, go to bed, wake up, and edit. This video is gonna be so long. As of right now, there are 16 tracks on the regular edition, and there are 4 additional tracks on different variants. So there's one called The Manuscript on that variant, The Bolter on another variant, The Albatross on another one, and The Black Dog. So I have no idea if those will be available for streaming. They are, we'll listen. If not, we'll just do the regular album. And knowing Miss Swiftie, there's probably a 2 a.m. or a 3 a.m. variant coming or something. So that might be a different video because I can only imagine how long this one is going to be. It's almost time. Are you ready for it? Okay, it's 12:04. They've not loaded on YouTube, and I wanted to watch the lyric videos, so we're gonna listen to it on Amazon Music. And then I couldn't remember my Amazon password because everything is saved, so had to reset some stuff, but we're here. All right, up first is Fortnite featuring Post Malone. And this is probably the song that I am the most excited for because something on TikTok, it's floating around. I don't know if that's a leak or if that's AI. So it is a bop if that's the real one, but let's find out. Let's find out.
I was supposed to be sent away, but they forgot to come.
Well, that doesn't sound like the one online on TikTok.
I was a functioning alcoholic till nobody noticed my new aesthetic.
Is Taylor an alcoholic? Never heard that one.
All of this to say, I hope you're okay, but you're the reason. And no one here's to blame. Sometimes I
It's a bop. I like it.
In my backyard, turn into good neighbors. Your wife waters flowers. I wanna kill her. All my mornings are Monday stuff.
Okay, I wish I had the lyrics, but I thought it said, your wife bought us flowers. I wanted to kill her. Is that right?
The effects were temporary.
Guessing.
I love you. It's ruining my life.
Oh, that's where that I love you, it's ruining my life came from the installation at the Grove. Okay, and then I can hear Post Malone coming in on here. I had no idea Post Malone could sing until he did, was it America the Beautiful at the Super Bowl? And then the collab with Beyonce, Levi's Jeans, I think is my favorite my favorite track on Cowboy Carter. So let's finish this song. I touched you for only a fortnight. Who do we think that's about?
Good neighbors, your wife waters flowers. I wanna kill her.
Yes, your wife bought us flowers. I wanna kill her. I cannot wait to see the music video for this, which comes out, I guess, today, technically, at 8 p.m. And I'll be at a Taylor Swift party, so.
Neighbors, my husband is cheating. I wanna kill her.
Okay, I don't know if you could hear that, but I think she's saying, move to Florida and then I'll call you up. So what was 2 weeks in Florida? Who is this song about? Because she was with Joe for 6 years. So this is not Joe. That was an interesting song. I like it. I can see why she chose it to be. It's going to be the lead single. There's a music video and why it is track number one. It's boppy and I like it. So that's definitely one I'm going to listen to over and over again. Usually Amazon Music has lyrics. So there were some things in there that I know I didn't catch on the first listen. We're going to continue with track two, The Tortured Poets Department, the title track. So we'll see. My prediction on this one is that it is a play on the Tortured Man's Club, which was a group chat that her ex Joe had with some of his mates. So let's see. Ooh. Already I like the beat. I thought this would be like slow and sad, but so far it's kind of got a good beat.
Your typewriter at my apartment, straight from the Tortured Poets Department.
Ooh, you left your typewriter at my apartment, straight from the Tortured Poets Department. I like it.
I think some things I never say, like who uses typewriters anyway?
Who uses typewriters anyway?
Walking self-sabotage mode, throwing spikes down on the rope. But I've seen this episode and still love the show. Who else decodes you? And who's gonna call you like me? And who's gonna know you if not me? Chocolate. We declare Charlie Puth should be a bigger artist. scratch your head, you fall asleep like a tattoo golden retriever.
Oh, I scratch your head and you fall asleep like a tattooed golden retriever. Joe didn't have tattoos. This is Maddie Healy. Maddie Healy, because I don't think any of her other exes had tattoos. Maybe, I don't know. Ha! Wow, she sounds mighty angry in this one too. So I like this. I like this one a lot.
Sometimes I wonder if you're gonna screw this up with me. But you told Lucy you'd kill yourself if I ever leave. And I had said that to Jack about you, so I felt seen. Everyone we know understands why it's meant to be. Cause we're crazy. So tell me, who else is gone?
I don't know who Lucy is, but Jack I know is Jack Antonoff, her producer and co-writer on this song.
I ring off my middle finger and put it on the wall.
Ooh. So he takes her ring off her middle finger and puts it on her wedding ring finger, and that's the closest she's ever come. Huh.
Dylan Thomas, I'm not Patti Smith. You seem to Chelsea Hotel. We're two idiots. Who's gone?
Okay, I know who Dylan Thomas is, but I have no idea who Patti Smith is, so I probably should know, but I don't. But I'm gonna Google that later. I like the harmony in it. I like the lyrics. I like the production. So I wasn't sure what to think of this album. I was thinking maybe it would be more like folklore-y Evermore, or, but it's kind of like more Midnightsy. I'm not sure yet, but I did notice that everything just loaded on YouTube. So I'm going to switch over to YouTube so that I can see lyrics, because I don't know. I feel like I need to see lyrics. Okay, so up is track 3, My Boy Only Breaks His Favorite Toys. And this is one of the songs where Taylor Swift is the only writer, so.
Oh, here we go again. The voices in his head.
Oh, they're not lyric videos.
And our days are wild.
Well, darn it. I thought there were lyric videos. Do we not have lyric videos? Woman, I need some lyrics. I guess we don't have lyric videos, so I probably could stay on Amazon Music and not have ads, so let's do that. Up next is track number 3, My Boy Only Breaks His Favorite Toys. I feel like this one's gonna be a sad one.
Oh, here we go again, the voices in his head, call the rain to end. Ah.
Ooh, she sounds like Lana Del Rey in here. Absolutely sounds like Lana.
Our days are wild, the sickest army ball, purchased at the mall, rivulets descend, my plastic smile. But you should have seen him when he first got me. My boy only breaks his favorite toys.
The queen of sandcastles he destroys.
There was a litany of reasons why we could have played for keeps this time. I know I'm just repeating myself, put me back on myself first. Pull the string and I'll tell you that he runs because he loves me.
He loves me.
Because you should have seen him when he first saw me. My boy.
because you should have seen him when he first saw me. Oh, there was danger in the heat of my touch. He saw forever and he smashed it up. She sounds so angry on this song. And I can totally understand where she's coming from. She sounds angry. I feel like I need my Taylor Swift, my comfort blanket now. I'm ready for it. My best friend down at the sandlot. This I recognize. This song. This is why I love Taylor Swift, is because she's not writing about unrelatable things. She's writing about things that everyone experiences. So pretty much everyone has gone through a breakup and can relate to this experience that she is describing. And she just puts into words so perfectly what I cannot. Stole my tortured heart. Left all these broken parts. Left all these broken parts. Told me I'm That one. That one. Yeah. Number four is Down Bad. Ooh. It's got a different tune to it. Like a different... I don't even know what instrument that is or if that's a synth. Did you really beat me up? In a cloud of sparkling dust. Just to do experiments on. Tell me I was the chosen one. Show me that this world is bigger than us. Then sent me back where I came from. For a moment I knew cosmic love. Now I'm down bad crying at the gym. Everything comes out teenage petulance. Fuck it if I can't have him. I might just die, it would make no difference. Down bad, breaking up in blood. Staring at the sky, come back and pick me up. This was a breakup song. I was down bad, crying at the gym. Oh, we gotta... I need comfort. I gotta have comfort. This is how we're going. Where's my tea? Forget if I can't have us. I might just not get up. I might stay down bad. Forget if I can't have him. Now I'm down bad, crying at the gym. Ooh, I liked that difference. When she talks about heaven struck, she was using her like falsetto and her upper register. And then when she started back into the chorus of down bad, and then she went down to her lower register. So the difference of that is very unique. But this, the lyrics too, did you take all my old clothes? Like, I hope Joe didn't take her clothes. Me up, forget if I can't have us. I might just not get up, I might stay down bad. Like I lost my twin, forget if I can't have him. I loved your hostile takeovers, encounters closer and closer. All your indecent exposures, how dare you say that it's... I'll build you a fort on some planet where they can all understand it. How dare you think it's romantic. Safe and stranded. Fuck it, I was in love. F it, I was in love. So fuck you if I can't have us. Ooh, angry. This is angry Taylor album. Angry, angry Taylor. Fuck it, I was in love. Down bad, crying I lost my twin. By the way, I don't know how to edit bad words out, so sorry. There's a lot of them in this song.
Like I lost my twin, fuck it, I can't have him. Down by leaving at this shit, fuck it, I can't have him.
The production on that was so good. Like, you can feel her just raw anger in that song. And you know, we've been there, just F it if you can't have him, you know? It's time for track 5, So Long London. And if you know track 5, it is notoriously her most vulnerable, her saddest. It's just, and it's usually like a fan favorite, so. So Long London.
So, so long, long, long.
Oh, that is not what I was expecting. That's so pretty and like almost like ethereal.
London, London, so, so long, long, long. London, London, so, so long, 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 London.
Oh, now we have the beat drop.
My mind, fairy lights through the mist. I kept calm and carried the weight of the rift. Pulled him in.
Oh, she kept calm and carried. Such a British thing.
Tighter each time he was drifting away.
She held tighter each time he was drifting away.
My spine split from carrying us up the hill. Wet through my clothes, weary bones caught the chill. Stop trying to make him laugh, stop trying to drill the safe. Thinking, how much sad did you think I had? Did you think I had in me?
How much sad did you think I had in me?
Oh, the tragedy, so long, London. You'll find someone. I didn't opt in to be.
Oh, so long, London. You'll find someone.
Your odd man out. I found at the club she's heard great things about. I left all I knew, you left me at the house by the heath. I stopped CPR, after all it's no use. The spirit was gone, we would never.
Oh, I stopped CPR, which is a play on You're Losing Me. If you know that song.
Come to, and I'm pissed off you let me give you all that youth for free. For so long, London, stitches
So long, London, two graves, one gun. She's so mad that she gave most of her youth to you. So long, London.
I'll find someone.
You did find someone, Taylor, and his name is Travis Kelce, and he is perfect for you. And he loves you so much, and you are so happy. I know you don't know this when you're writing this song, but it turns out okay.
And you say I abandoned the ship, but I was going down with it. My white knuckle dying grip, holding tight to your quiet resentment. And my friend said it isn't right to be scared. Every day of love affair, every breath feels like where's there. When you're not sure if he wants to be there.
This is also like reminiscent of the Great War. It gives me those vibes. This is, I wonder if she'll ever perform this live, because this is rough. I'm almost getting a little teary myself.
You swore that you loved me, but where were the clues? I died on the altar waiting for the proof. You sacrificed us to the gods of your bluest days. And I'm just getting color back into my face. I'm just mad as...
Well, she put that reference, you sacrificed us to the bluest of days. In some of her previous albums, she's used blue to refer to the color of Joe. So everything is blue because of his ocean blue eyes. Just, Joe has a lot of blue. So this is, yeah, this is definitely a Joe song because obviously he's British. Gut-wrenching. That truly was gut-wrenching. I almost feel I'm out of tea. Like, I need to go get some more tea. That was... I don't know that I'm gonna listen to that one on repeat. It's not a bop. Oh, I hope the next one's a bop. I need a bop after that. Oh, that was heart-wrenching, guys. Heart-wrenching. Next song up, track 6, is But Daddy, I Love Him. So my prediction is that this one is about Maddie Healy. Or it could be about getting her voice, because it's also a quote from Ariel in The Little Mermaid when she learns she gets her voice. So let's see what But Daddy, I Love Him is about. Apparently I have to sing that voice.
I forget how the West was won. I forget if this was ever fun. I just learned these people only raise you to cage you. Sarah's and Hannah's in the Sunday best, clutching their pearls, sighing, what a mess. I just learned these people try and save you, cause they hate you. Too high a horse for a simple girl to rise above it. They slammed the door on my whole world. The one thing I wanted. Now I'm running with my dress unbuttoned, screaming, but daddy, I love him. I'm having this baby. No, I'm not, but you should see your faces.
Oh. With my dress undone, screaming, but daddy, I love him. I'm having his baby. No, I'm not, but you should see your faces. What? What, Taylor Swift? What? What is happening in this song?
Down into Florida through the fences. No, I'm not coming to my senses. I know it's crazy, but it's the one I want. Dutiful thought around, my plans were laid. Tendrils tucked into a woven braid. Growing up precocious sometimes means not growing up at all. He was chaos, he was revelry. Bedroom eyes like a remedy.
He was chaos, he was revelry. Gotta be Maddie Healy. Gotta be Maddie Healy.
Soon enough, the elders had convened down at the city hall.
Oh, the elders had convened down at the city hall. I think that was her parents and her management team and Tree, which Tree Payne is her publicist. And I think they knocked some sense into her, but let's see.
Stay away from her, the saboteurs protested too much. Lord knows the words we never heard. Just screeching tires of true love.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah, this was about the fan outrage and her, I'm assuming her team's outrage when she started dating Matt Healy, who has made some racist comments and can be very problematic. I never heard of Matty Healy or the 1975 prior to Taylor dating him, so I don't know the whole backstory. I just know, like, a little bit.
There's a lot of people in town that I bestow upon my fakest smiles. Scandal does funny things to pride, but brings lovers closer. We came back when the heat died down. Went to my parents and they came around. All the wine moms are still holding out, but fuck 'em, it's over.
This song has like country vibes. This would be really good acoustically if she ever chooses to do this one, maybe at the Eras tour in the acoustic set. You know, at this point we have like no idea what she is doing with the Eras tour, if she's adding Tortured Poets into that or not. I have no clue, but this would be a really good acoustic song. Okay, that one, this is Angry Taylor album, if I ever had to say it. I don't feel as wrecked about that one, so I'll take off my emotional support blanket. On to track 8, Florida, with 3 exclamation points, featuring Florence and the Machine.
You can beat the heat if you beat the charges too. They said I was a cheat, I guess it must be true.
Ooh, they said I was a cheat. It must be true. Where's this going?
And my friends all smell like weed or little babies. And the city reeks of driving myself crazy. Little did you know your home's really only a town you're just a guest in. So you work your life away just to pay for a timeshare down in Destin, Florida. Drunk and I dared it to wash me away. Barricaded in the bathroom with a bottle of wine. Well, me and my ghost, we had a hell of a time, yes.
I love Florence's voice, but I have no idea what this song is about. I thought it was gonna be about when she announced her breakup. She was on tour, on the Eras tour in Tampa, Florida, but this does not give me that sort of vibe.
I'm haunted, but I'm feeling just fine. All my girls got their lace and their crimes, and your cheating husband disappeared. Well, no one asks any questions here. So I did my best to sink into the swamp. Is that a bad thing to say in a song? Then did you know your 100 home in town, you'll get arrested.
Any connection to Florida? Like Destin, Florida? I'm so confused by this. Reddit will tell me, TikTok will tell me tomorrow, but as of right now, at 12:56 in the morning, I have absolutely no idea.
Oh, I need to forget, so take me to Florida. I got some regrets, I'll bury them in Florida. Tell me I'm despicable, say it's unforgivable.
Their voices sound so good together, honestly.
Florida is one hell of a drug. Florida,
I am so confused. I have no idea. I have no clue. But, I mean, it was a pretty song. Her voice, I don't know if it's just this album or the writing style, but she just sounds like Lana Del Rey. All right, our next song we have is one that I think Taylor Swift is the sole writer on, and it's called Guilty as Sin? Question mark. So who is Guilty as Sin?
Drowning in the Blue Nile, he sent me downtown.
Drowning in the Blue Nile, we got the blue again. Oh, I was wrong. Taylor Swift was not the sole writer on this one. I looked at the wrong song, so no.
While my boredom's bone deep, this cage was once just fine. Am I allowed to cry? I dream of cracking locks, throwing my life to the wolves or the ocean rocks, crashing into him tonight. Paradox, I'm seeing visions, am I by, oh my, oh why.
Ooh, okay. Okay, I think this is Miss Swift talking about fantasizing about being with some other guy, because she's talking about how her cage and like cages and bird cages are like a common theme with her. Like she always feels like she's in a gilded cage. So her cage was just fine, but now she just wants to crack locks and throw herself on ocean rocks.
What if he's written mine on my upper thigh, only in my mind?
Ooh, what if he's written on my upper thigh, only in my mind? Touching his skin, can I be guilty of sin?
In all of me, we've already done it in my head. It's make-believe.
I'm going to a Taylor Swift themed all ages event at my local library next week, and we were gonna like listen to this song. This stuff is like so explicit. We will not be probably playing this album. I know we're not gonna be playing this album in my classroom. I have a bunch of Swifties, but I think this one is for the grown-ups. Yep.
How can I be guilty as sin? What if I roll the stone away? They're gonna crucify me anyway. What if the way you hold me is actually what's holy?
If I roll the stone away, they're gonna crucify me anyway. So if she and Joe break up for any reason, they're gonna crucify her.
If long-suffering propriety is what they want from me, they don't know how you've haunted me so stunningly. I choose you and me religiously. I hadn't heard it in.
Wow, that was a song. That was another relatable one. I suspect that most of us in a relationship at one point or another have fantasized about being with someone else. Yeah, and I think that's all I'm gonna say about that. Next song up is number 7, fresh out of the slammer. What could it be about?
Now, pretty baby, I'm running back home to you. Fresh out the slammer, I know who my first call will be to. Fresh out the slammer.
fresh out the slammer, I know who my first call will be to. I think this one's about Maddie Healy again. So I think when she and Joe ended, I think her first call was to Maddie Healy. Okay, silent winter, silent dinners. I thought she said he was with her, but then maybe not. I really need the lyric videos, so I don't know. Gray and blue, again, another reference to Joe, blue. For just one hour of sunshine. Toss the ashes off the ledge. Those nights you kept me going, swirled you into all of my poems. Now we're at the starting line, I did my time. Ooh, I worked you, all those poems, I worked you into the lines. Now, pretty baby, I'm running to the house. We still wait up in that porch light, please. Ooh, we're changing to like beats here. To the one who says I'm the girl of his American dreams. Yep, the girl of his American dreams. Because Maddie Healy's British and Joe's British. Travis is all American though. At the park where we used to sit on children's swings, wearing imaginary rings. Oh, wearing imaginary rings. But it's gonna be alright, I did my time. Yeah, that one kind of describes the end of one relationship and the beginning of another. And if I'm not mistaken, it seems like there might be a little overlap. Okay, on to the next one. We have made it to track 10, Who's Afraid of Little Old Me? And this is one that Taylor Swift wrote by herself. And I suspect it is about either Scooter Braun or Scott Borchetta, or maybe both. I don't know. But I think it has something to do with the reclaiming of her masters. So let's see if I'm right.
The who's who of who's that is poised for the attack. But my bare hands paved their paths. You don't get to tell me about sad.
Oh, you don't get to tell me about sad. Oh, that's such a good line. Hey, I need you to sit, please. Okay?
If you wanted me dead, you should have just said.
Oh, if you wanted me dead, you should have just said. Reminds me of the one. It is one in the morning. You know, that song, that one. I'll probably have to put it here because it is 1:07 in the morning and my brain has stopped functioning about which song. Anywhere I want, just not home. That one, yep, that one.
Nothing makes me feel more alive. So I leap from the gallows and I levitate down your street. Crash the party like a record scratch as I scream. Who's afraid of little old me? You should be.
Ooh, who's afraid of little old me? You should be. Oh, yeah, this is exactly what that's about. This is about that war. Yep. with Scooter Braun and Scott Borchetta and getting her masters and the re-recording all of the Taylor's Version projects.
The scandal was contained. The bullet had just grazed. At all costs, keep your good name. You don't get to tell me you feel bad. Is it a wonder I broke? Let's hear one more joke. Then we could all just laugh until I cry. So tell me everything is not about me. But what if it is?
You tell me everything is not about me, but what if it is? Oh, that's a great line.
Then say they didn't do it to hurt me. But what if they did? How disturbed this has made me. You wouldn't last an hour in the asylum where they raised me. So all you kids can still say that I'll sue you if you step on my lawn. That I'm fearsome, and I'm wretched, and I'm wrong. You cage me, and then you call me crazy.
No one likes a mad woman.
Who's afraid of little old me?
So this one had some, like, asylum themes in it. Where she was, it said the asylum where they raised me. There was a lot of speculation online that the trailer for the music video and like the little teaser reel that she posted was an insane asylum. So I don't know. Next up, we have track number 11. I can fix him. And then parentheses. No, really, I can. I think this is Maddie Healy. We'll see. Ooh.
The smoke cloud billows out his mouth like a freight train through a small town.
Yeah, because I don't think Joe smoked, so yeah. Maddie Healy.
The jokes that he told across the bar were revolting and far too loud. They shake their heads saying, God help her when I tell him he's my man. But your good Lord doesn't need to lift a finger. I can fix him. No, really, I can.
Another relatable one. We've all had the bad boy or the somebody who just wasn't as good as we thought he should be. We're like, we can fix him. We can fix him.
And only I can. The dopamine races through his brain on a six-lane Texas highway. His hand so callous from his pistol softly traces hearts on my face. And I could see it from a mile away, a perfect case for my certain skill set. He had a halo of the highest grade. He just hadn't met me yet. Good boy, that's right. Come close. I'll show you heaven if you'll be an angel all night. Trust me, I can handle me a dangerous man. No, really, I can.
Maybe really I can't, because she ended up not being able to fix Maddie Healy and she had to end that relationship. But then she met Travis Kelce and all is well. Woo! That was some song. Alright, next up is number 12, L-O-M-L. So I've seen a lot of speculation online that this could be Love of My Life, but let's see and find out. The piano. So that's the first just piano she's had on this so far.
If we know the steps anyway, we embroidered the memories of the time I was away. Stitching, we were just kids, babe. I said, I don't mind. It takes time. I thought I was better safe than starry-eyed. I felt a glow like this, never before and never since. If you know it in one glimpse, it's legendary. You and I go from one kiss to getting married, still alive, killing time.
Ooh, I think this is a Joe song. I really do. You know what I've noticed and what I've heard is that there are no glitter pen songs on this album, and there has not been a single glitter gel pen song. There's a lot of fountain pens, a lot of fountains. This is just such a raw, angry album. Like, in that, talking about those five stages of grief, like this, she's really in the anger phase with most of
that. Holy Ghost, you told me I the love of your life.
Yep, love of your life, love of my life.
Love of your
told me I reformed you.
Paintings of hell.
Did she reform Joe? Because I just don't think she and Maddie Healy were together like a month publicly. I mean, there could have been some more time that we don't know about, but I wouldn't call, I don't know, I think that time period is too short to call someone the love of my life, but.
Sister, steal your girl, then make her cry.
Ooh, you shit talked me under the table, talking rings and talking cradles. Joe, this is a Joe song.
We almost had it all, dancing phantoms. I'll never leave, never mind.
I need my blanket. She changed love of my life, LOML, to loss of my life. Yeah, I had to have my emotional support blanket back. That was so sad. That's up there, and I think like Last Kiss is one of the saddest songs. I think that might like have taken the cake of the saddest song. Maybe. Up next, track number 13, we have I Can Do It with a Broken Heart. We just don't have any like upbeat dancey bops really, but I understand. But I need it after that, I need an upbeat. I need something. Maybe it is upbeat.
I can read your mind. She's having the time of her life.
Who's she? Who's she having the time of her life? Who is she?
there in her glittering prime, the lights refract sequined stars off her silhouette every night. I can show you lights. Cause I'm a real tough kid, I can handle my shit.
That beat dropped. Okay.
Gotta fake it till you make it, and I did. Lights, camera, bitch, smile, even when you wanna die. He said he loved me all his life, but that life was too short. Breaking down, I hit the floor. All the pieces of me shattered as the crowd was chanting more.
Oh, pieces of me were breaking down as the crowd was chanting more. I'm so sorry that we ever made you feel that way.
Hitting my marks, cause I can do it with a broken heart.
Oh, it's boppy though. Okay, I mean, depression is not funny, but you've got this upbeat poppy dance number. I'm so depressed, I act like it's my birthday, with like club thumping music.
Every day. I'm so obsessed with him, but he avoids me like the plague.
Oh, he avoids me like the plague. Now we slow down again.
I've been doing it since he left. I keep finding his things in drawers, crucial evidence I didn't imagine the whole thing. I'm sure I can pass this test.
Oh, if you've been following along with like some of the clues she's released this week, it is, I hereby conduct a postmortem investigation. So this song has, I found evidence, like that I can, evidence of this relationship in the drawers or something. Again, one something in the morning, can't think. If you can hear her, but she's like laughing, saying, I'm miserable and nobody even knows. So far, I really like this one. It's very vulnerable, but like vulnerable, but with Jack's production behind it, it just is like this juxtaposition of this very like sad song, sad lyrics, like depression with like boppy music. So I predict this one's going to be the one that people make TikTok dances to so far. We've made it to track 14, the smallest man who ever lived. I have a very strong suspicion that this is about Scooter Braun. So let's see.
Was any
Oh, she took that big deep breath again before, like she did in You're Losing Me.
It true.
Ooh, was any of it even true?
Gazing at me starry eyed in your Jehovah's Witness suit. Who the fuck was that guy? You tried to buy some pills from a friend of friends of mine.
All right, who's dressed up in a Jehovah's Witness suit trying to buy pills?
They just ghosted you.
They ghosted you.
Now you know what it feels like. And I don't even want you back, I just want to know. Rusting my sparkling summer was the goal. And I don't miss what we had, but could some smallest man who ever.
All right, I'm not quite sure who this one is about. Somebody's buying pills and then got ghosted.
In public showed me off.
Ooh, who showed her off in public? Not Joe.
Then sank in stoned oblivion. You didn't measure up in any measure of a man.
Ooh, this is brutal. This is just vicious. Vicious. Okay.
My sparkling summer was the goal.
Rusting my sparkling summer. So yeah, I think this is Maddie Healy.
Sent by someone who wanted me dead. Did you sleep with her garden underneath?
Were you sent by someone who wanted me dead? Ooh, was he put up to it by Scooter Braun and Scott Borchetta? I don't know, I'm theorizing.
Sexy once it wasn't forbidden. I would have died for your sins. Instead I just died inside. And you deserve prison, but you won't get time. You'll slide into inboxes and slip through the bars. You crashed my party and your rental car. You said normal girls were boring, but you were gone by the morning. You kicked out the stage lights, but you're still performing. And then
yeah, didn't Maddie Healy kick out some stage lights? Isn't that what, I have to Google that, but somebody did, I think it was him.
Plain sight you hid, but you are what you did. And I'll forget you, but I'll never forgive the smallest man who ever lived.
You know, we thought this album was gonna be like R.I.P. Joe, and there's a couple, but I think it's R.I.P. Maddie Healy. We have made it to track 15, The Alchemy.
Ooh. This happens once every few lifetimes.
I've noticed already one thing with this album is that she doesn't really have much of an introduction. Like, you might get one or two beats and then she starts in with the vocals. Just very different.
These chemicals hit me like white. What if I told you I'm back? The hospital was a drag. Worst sleep that I ever had. I circled you on a map. I haven't come around in so long. But I'm coming back so strong. So when I touch down, call the amateurs and cut them from the team. Ditch the clowns, get the crown, baby. I'm the one to be. Cause the sign on your heart said it's still reserved for me. Honestly, who are we to fight the alchemy? Hey, you, what if I told you we're cool? That child's play back in school is forgiven under my rule. I haven't come around in so long. Lift you up over their heads, beers sticking to the floor. Cheers chanted cause they said there was no chance. Trying to be the greatest in the league. Where's the trophy? He just comes running over.
Kelsey, this has got so many football references, but I thought this was like before she met Travis Kelsey, but I don't know. It's got football stuff, guys. Football stuff.
This happens once every few lifetimes. These chemicals hit me like white.
I don't know, but it seems like she's on a happier note. Like, we started out not great, very angry, sad, and we're making our way to happy acceptance, maybe. I'm gonna see if anyone else thinks that one's about Travis Kelce, because I have my suspicions. All right, and we have made it to track 16, Clara Bow, who was like an old Hollywood actress back in the day and was like the original Hollywood it girl. So let's see. Ooh, I like that guitar.
You look like Clara Bow in this light. Remarkable all your life. Did you know you'd be picked like a rose? I'm not trying to exaggerate, but I think I might die if it happened. Small town, thought I'd see the lights of Manhattan. This town is fake, but
I think she is comparing the parallels of her life to Clara Bow, but let's see if I'm on the right track here.
The real thing, breath of fresh air through the smoke.
Okay, so in the installation in the Grove, they, and part of the library, they add new things every day. And I think the last thing they added today was a tambourine with lace on it, which I know was like a big thing with Stevie Nicks.
Out goes wild at her fingertips, half moonshine, a full eclipse. I'm gonna try your love.
Love that bridge. Beauty is the beast that roars down on all fours.
Wanting more.
Wanting more.
Only when your girlish glow flickers just so, do they let you know it's hell on earth to be heavenly. Them's the breaks.
Taylor Swift in this light.
Got edge. She never did the future's bright dazzling.
I finished all 16 tracks. It is 1:44 in the morning. And my first impressions, like, this is an angry album. I don't know that she's gonna have like a lot of boppy radio hits off this, but I bet it was cathartic for her to write. The production was good. I was way more Maddie Healy than I thought. I know I saw an article about the leaks and they said it was a lot of Maddie Healy. Yeah. So my favorite songs upon first listening, I think But Daddy, I Love Him was fun. I Can Do It With a Broken Heart was fun. I mean, they're all really good. She's just an exquisite songwriter. But wow, you gotta be in like a good place to listen to this album. So, all right, there may be a 2 a.m. release coming out here in 15 minutes, or I don't know why all the clocks kept pointing to 2. If there is, maybe I'll react to those songs. So, I will see you on the next one. This is gonna take me forever to edit. Bye, guys. It's a double album. I literally got done filming at about 1:55 a.m. and then I walked out, got on Instagram, played around for a little bit, came back, and there was a post saying it's a double album with 15 more songs. Oh, maybe I'll react to them tomorrow. I gotta go to bed. I'm too tired. I feel like I'm like, there's, wow, 31 plus the variant songs, and who knows what else she'll come up with. Wow. Oh my gosh. I don't even know how I'm gonna edit and film, and oh my gosh.